confident. I've always.
Wait. I've never seen this before. That's how it starts off. I always been like this. Yada 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 yada. Wait. Let me laugh. Was that the plan? Hold up. Nigga, this my stream. I wasn't even ready for that. I'm sorry. Hold on. We gotta. Can we get a replay? I didn't know that was coming. Nobody told me that was on the menu today. That wasn't scheduled. Nowhere on my agenda did it say that.
Let's go. Let's go.
Body yaddy. Okay. What's she talking about? Getting shot? Where did she get shot? In her body, yada yada yada. Why would you start off with that? Hey, Twitch. I don't know about the TOS shit. This is her. I ain't putting no shit, nigga. I don't play Megan Thee Stallion. I don't listen to shit. I don't watch her twirl. I don't do none of that shit. I ain't got nothing to do with this. But this is news and update. I like to stay updated with what's going on in the world. Try to share with other people that want to know what's going on in the world. I don't know if a lot of people know. I'm pretty sure some do. But again, I got followers from Germany and Japan and all kind of shit. They don't give a fuck about this. So for all the foreigners, all my foreign followers, this girl talk about she's supposed to be a rapper and she said that she got shot by another rapper. This was probably about like 2-3 years ago or some shit, but nobody believed her. Everybody trying to figure out what's going on. She finally, after like 2-3 years, sat down and tried to explain what's going on. And again, like I told y'all, I haven't seen this, but the internet and everybody in America, this shit don't make no sense. From men, women, shit, other female rappers. Like nobody. Even other female victims saying shit like this don't make sense. But you know what? I'm going to let y'all assess everything. Let y'all evaluate the situation. Y'all, go ahead. I just let y'all know what this supposed to be. But we're going to watch this. It's only like 12 minutes. Yeah, like 12 minutes. Let's see what she's talking about. Let's give her a chance. She wants to protect the black man. The heart gets warmer. Let's see if we can protect the black woman.
I've been like this all my life. I've always been confident. I've always been loud.
Oh, man. Hey, one more other thing, though. Megan Thee Stallion kind of big. When I first seen Megan Thee Stallion, it was on Instagram. I was going through like social media. I didn't know who this was. They was talking about this big ass, this black girl that was extra tall. She taller than all the guys and all this other type of shit. And they was like making all these little memes and stuff, putting her next to all kind of niggas that was like this tall to her and shit. When I saw, I thought they was just making fun of some girl that went viral or some shit. I'm like, nigga, leave her alone, nigga. She tall, so what? Nigga, I'm tall too, nigga. What the fuck? Leave her alone. I went and I saw another video of her twerking. All that shit was dismissed. I'm over here talking about leave her alone when I really seen the videos of her performing. I retract my statement. I retract all of my statements. Nigga, look. She's such a nice girl. Leave her alone. She's tall. God made her that way. She's black. She's beautiful. There's nothing wrong with her. And then nigga go to her Instagram, nigga.
I've been like this all my life. I've always been confident. I've always been loud. I've always been outgoing. Like, I've always just enjoyed entertaining. And when I look now, I'm like, dang, you really do this.
When did you know you were good at this?
I feel like I wrote my first like rap when I was 7, and I didn't tell my mama, well, I did tell my mama the rap, but I didn't tell her I wanted to be a rapper. But I saw her rapping, and I would go to the studio with her, and I would, like, sit in the waiting room, waiting at the door, listening to what she in there saying, and I'm like, okay, yeah, that sounds fire. I like that.
Girl, I could do that at 7.
I could do that. And when I got to college, everybody just knew me as the Stallion, and she rapped, and I was like, okay, this is my identity. Yes, this is what we wanted.
H-Town made the, H-Town raised the. Damn, I'm so proud to be your H-Town native.
5 years after Megan Thee Stallion posted this dorm room video, she made her debut on the Billboard Hot 100 list with the song Big Ol' Freak. That same year, her mother passed away. She had already lost her father when she was just 15. I asked her what she had learned from her parents, a question that made her emotional.
I didn't mean to make you cry. I was just curious about the impact and effect they've had on your life.
They were my best friends. It was only the three of us all the time. Like when I went to school, I feel like it was a little different with me interacting with other kids. So like.
Nigga, these your baby pictures?
They were my best friends. It was only the three of us.
That was you? That's when Megan was a pony, not a stallion. Nigga, is that a jail picture? Is that a gel pitch? Wait, hold on. Where they at? Why you got brick walls? What is he wearing? Was he a janitor? Like, I don't, like, the only time I see people, like as for men, like jobs and shit, and pictures and shit. This is like a prison photo, nigga. I just. I mean, was it take your kid and girl to work day, nigga? Was he a janitor? There's no reason for him to be dressed like this, and he does, like, a professional job. I just...
So all the time. Like, when I went to school, I feel like it was a little different with...
Another baby picture. Failed. Failed, nigga. You, like, you just a little droopy on that. You like, you just a little bit too droopy.
Yeah.
Nigga, tell me that wasn't Megan Thee Stallion as a baby. Like, the last picture was okay. This one, look like she's still developing. Tell me she don't like droopy, though. No? Then you're lying to me. You lying to me. I know exactly what droopy look like. You look just like that with the long ears, nigga. That's all she missing.
Me interacting with other kids. So, like, they would kind of pick with me a little bit. Like, I was so tall.
I'm not gonna lie, she do kind of like her mama. You, that's your mama. The way she looking down there, your face definitely changed.
Really? They just really let me know, like, you can't ever let somebody else's insecurities make you insecure.
I'm a savage.
God.
In May 2020, Megan Thee Stallion's hit song, Savage, is inescapable, and so is she.
Savage is everywhere. You are a huge success, which brings us to July 12, 2020. Let's go there, Megan. That night changed everything for you.
Rapper Tory Lanez has been charged with shooting artist Megan Thee Stallion during an argument.
Megan Thee Stallion hit by multiple gunshots.
There was an argument in the car?
It was an argument because I was ready to go and everybody else wasn't ready to go. Mm-hmm. But that's like normal friend stuff. Like,
yeah.
We fuss about silly stuff all the time. Mm-hmm.
All the time.
I never put my hands on anybody. I never raised my voice too loud. Like, this was one of the times where it was like, it shouldn't have got this crazy.
It shouldn't have escalated to the way that it did. Can you just briefly walk us through what happened that night? It starts, you're at a party at Kylie Jenner's house.
Had went there and we were just hanging out and I was ready to go because I had been there all day.
So you guys end up in a car, you, Tory Lanez, your friend at the time, Kelsey, and his driver slash security.
Mm-hmm. Tory Lanez, whose real name is Daystar Peterson, is a Grammy nominated rapper and singer from Canada. Kelsey Harris was one of Megan Thee Stallion's best friends from Houston.
There was an argument and you get out of the car, right?
At that point, the argument wasn't even with me. Like, the argument was with the two people in the backseat. So So I asked the driver to pull the car over, like, I'm done with this. And I should have stayed out of the car. Like, I should have not got back in the car. Mm-hmm. And they was like, Megan, just get back in the car. We almost there. Like, just get back in. Mm-hmm. So I get back in the car. It's like it's getting worse. Like,
the arguing in the car.
The arguing in the car is getting worse. And I don't want to be in this car no more. Like, because I see it's getting crazy. Mm-hmm. So I get out the car and it's like everything happens so fast. Yes. And all I hear is this man screaming, is he said, dance, and he started shooting. And I'm just like, oh my God. Like, he shot a couple of times. Mm-hmm. And I
so
was so scared.
So is he in the car shooting from the car, Megan?
He is standing up over the window, okay, shooting. Mm-hmm. And
hold on, now listen. Tory Lanez, I don't know if you're ever gonna see this video. He might not ever see it. Listen, nigga, you too short to be trying to shoot over a window. He too short. Case dismissed. Case fucking dismissed. Hold on, nigga. You ain't gonna lie to me. You lie to them dumbass niggas. You ain't lying. To court. We taking this shit to fucking court, nigga. This bitch is guilty. Where my gavel, nigga? Where my fucking gavel? This nigga really gonna sit here and then tell me. Say it again. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I think we found our solid evidence in this case. Can we just play back like about like 10, 15 seconds? This maybe right there. What's that? 49? Where we at right now?
I didn't even want him.
No. We at 420. Go back about 10. Yeah, go about 20 seconds. Squeeze. What'd she say? Say
and it again. He said, dance. And he started shooting, and I'm just like, oh my God. Like, he shot a couple of times. And I was
so scared.
So
is he in the car shooting from the car, Megan?
He is standing up over the window.
Bam! Guilty! Guilty, I say. Guilty! This bitch talking about, oh my God. No. Nigga, shall we Google? We about to go. Hey, listen. I upgraded stream, bitch. This is not the time, nigga. I'm on some new shit. I can do some new shit. As a matter of fact, I'm about to prove shit. Go ahead, put in Tory Lanez and Google. We're all about to welcome, join in. Huddle up, everybody. Huddle up. We got some information against Miss Stallion. Go ahead. Tory Lanez, Canadian rapper. / singer, / songwriter, / not tall enough to shoot over the glass. I want his height. What kind of car was it, nigga? I don't give a fuck if that motherfucker was a Tonka. I don't give a fuck if it was one of the little cars that the kids be playing with, nigga. That nigga can't shoot over a Hot Wheels window. That nigga not tall enough for that shit. Don't lie. Don't do that. That was the wrong move to make right there. Your whole case and everything just... That just fell apart. Height, nigga, hold on. Yeah, height. Pull up that height. It's Tory Lanez 5'3", nigga. I don't know. Why are you asking me the question? I'm asking you. What type of shit is this? Hold on, man. I need accurate evidence. We about to solve the case right now. We about to solve the case right now. I promise you. He cannot even look over that. He shot over the glass window. So he was still in the car while he did this. I thought he was outside and he said dang while you were shooting. So he did all that while he was in the car. Can I get the height? That nigga is not 5'7". Now that is another damn lie. You guilty. Google, who been searching this shit? This must have been one of them Megan Thee Stallion fans. He has to be 5'7". Either that or one of his fans that just can't believe he really that fucking short. That nigga's a mini-me, nigga. Him and Bow Wow competing. Him and Bow Wow's competing. I know they are, nigga. Give him the height, nigga. How come you got his age, his birthday? You got where this nigga's from? Y'all got how, like, this nigga hairline is like 47 millimeters or some shit away. Like, y'all got the nigga hairline and all kind of shit. How come I can't get his height? I think I got his birthday, born July 27th. Wait, you born? Wait, hold on. Wait, your birthday is July 27th. My brother birthday is that same day, nigga. Hold up, nigga. Why you and my brother got the same? I never seen that before. My bad. Hold on. It's good. But you see how I can pull up information. It'll be about everything else. I know y'all can't see what I'm saying. I'm trying to pull this shit up. Hold on, Screech. Hold on. Nigga, I need the height, though. I'm not gonna lie. He probably paid people to take that shit off the internet. He said, you know what? I give you a little bit extra. You just leave that part out. We gonna figure this shit out, though. What is Tory Lanez's height? Nigga. Alright, but look, nigga, fuck the height, nigga. We know he ain't past 5'5". We know that for a fact. Nigga, you ain't past 5'5". Don't even lie to me, nigga. I just know a nigga that ain't past 5'5", you ain't shooting over the window. You just, that's not possible, nigga. Did he have a car seat? A car seat with the booster? That nigga ain't shooting over no window. That don't make no sense to me at all. I don't know why I'm even, like, shit like that made me want to just turn the shit off. But for the sake of the video and everything else, let it go. Height, age, and everything else, nigga. Hold on, nigga. Don't give me centimeters, nigga. I'm not trying to do all that extra shit. Nigga said centimeters and shit. Nigga. The hell is this? You making a cake, nigga? What type of shit? Ramp. I don't know if this is real. Is this real? Hold on. Hold on. I guess the nigga 5'3", nigga. I guess he 5'3". I ain't gonna lie. I don't know. Y'all wanna see what I see? Let's go PC real quick, Screech. Y'all see this right here? I don't know if y'all can see it. I'm over here in Tory Lanez biography, nigga. Wiki, nigga. Whatever this shit is. 27. But see, it say 5'3". He 5'3", nigga. Damn. These niggas got this shit in centimeters, meters, and everything. Nigga, they got your ass in kilograms. Oh, shit. Hey, nigga, if you 5'3", though. Yeah. Nigga ain't reaching over shit, Screech. Reaching over a window? Nah, Flynn. Nah, Screech. Oh, was that a smooth transition? Did I do that right? That's the first time I did that. I hope I did that right. I remember I was playing Grand Theft Auto, and I pressed one of this shit, and I accidentally switched the screen. I hope I got that right, though. But y'all see the height, though? Yeah, nigga. Nah. I feel like he would have to be in the car, standing on the seat, going outside the like this, maybe that, but that would just be too extra to even be doing all that. See, it still doesn't make sense to me. But she said he was shooting over the window. There's height requirements that go with that. I just want you to know. Like I just went through the trouble of researching this shit. Is he really not that tall though? It's just funny because it's true. It's funny because it's... Oh, man. That nigga be in the car like Toy Story. Nigga got to stand on the fucking armrest. Trying to pull up the shit to roll the window up. Nah, nigga. He wasn't shooting over no window. You can go ahead and scratch that off. You go ahead and eliminate that. I don't know why you even go to exaggerate that. You gave him a little bit too much credit at that point. Damn, he that tall? He shot over the window. I thought you was walking down the street and you turned around and then he shot you. I thought he was walking. Y'all both got the car. And now he was... Let's just let her do what she's gonna do. I'm sorry. I'm just
so fast. And all I hear is this man screaming. He said, dance. And he started shooting. And I'm just like, oh my God. Like, he shot a couple of times.
A couple of times.
And I
so
was
is he
scared.
In the car shooting from the car, Megan?
He is standing up over the window shooting. And I didn't even want to move. I didn't want to move too quick. Like, because I'm like, oh my God, if I take the wrong step, I don't know if he can shoot something that's like super important. I don't know if he could shoot me and kill me. Like,
were you afraid for your life at that time?
I was really scared because I had never been shot at before. And I looked down at my feet because I wasn't even, the adrenaline is pumping so hard. I'm not sure if he hit me. Like, I feel it, but I don't understand what's happening. So I look down at my feet and I'm like, oh my God, like I'm really bleeding. So I like drop down and I crawl in somebody's driveway. Like, I can't believe he shot me.
And what is he saying, Tory Lanez saying?
He's
after
apologizing.
He
said, I'm so sorry. Please don't tell nobody. I'll give y'all $1 million if y'all don't say nothing. And I'm like, what are you talking about? Like, what are you offering me money right now? Help me. Like, and if you're sorry, just help me. Like,
but at that moment,
we didn't even make it to the house. Like, somebody had already called the police, and it was like so many of them. It was helicopters. I was like, oh my God, we all about to die. Like, the George Floyd incident had just happened. The police are definitely very much shoot first, ask questions after. So I'm like, it's a hot gun in the car. I'm bleeding. I've been shot. They about to kill somebody. Like, something bad is about to happen.
So somebody hears the gunshots, they call the police. The police come, and they say what to you?
They tell everybody to get out of the car.
Get out of the car.
TMZ obtained video from that night.
And you could see the footage of me in the swimsuit, limping backwards, feet bleeding.
And they say to you, what happened here?
I don't remember everything they said to me, but I remember them asking me what's happening, what happened to you. And I didn't want them to kill any of us or shoot any of us. So I just said, I stepped on glass because I didn't
Why did you say that? Why didn't you say you shot me?
For some reason, I was just trying to protect all of us because I didn't want them to kill us. Like, even though this person just did this to me, my first reaction still was to try to save us. Like, I didn't want to see anybody die. So I just said, I stepped on glass. So when I see people trying to use that against me, like trying to act like I'm lying, oh, she stepped on glass, she never got shot. I'm the one who said I stepped on glass. I was lying to protect all of us. And sometimes I wish I really would have never said that.
You wish you would have just told the truth?
I wish I would have told the truth, but if it saved all of us from dying, then that's just probably what it was meant to be.
So when you told the police you stepped on glass, did they believe you?
I don't know.
So how did you go from the glass, did you go to the hospital?
So
right
they took
that?
Me straight to the hospital. And the police questioned me. And I said it was just glass.
You still stuck with that
story?
I
stuck with it. It was glass. And right as the officers were like, okay, we done with this, we leaving, the doctor came in and he was like, you know, you got bullets in both of your feet. Like, you got fragments in this foot.
Nigga, what the fuck?
Officers were like, okay, we done with
this. They pulling up everything.
The doctor came in and he was like, you know, you got bullets in both of your feet. Like,
all right, so since y'all want to pull some shit up, let me pull some shit up. I ain't playing with these niggas. Really though, Screech? Niggas already... the guy was still banging. Nigga, why would you put this up here? Why was it... Is a bullet does that? That look like that really could be glass, though. It look like it really could be glass. Because my whole thing is, your skin is peeled off, right? Where's the hole? A bullet usually pierces something and kind of explodes like where it is, but it'll make a soaker or it'll make a circle or a hole. You got a whole bunch of cut up shit like that's really glass. And then you want to put this shit up here like people that know what gunshots look like. does that really like a gunshot? At that point, it'd be like, maybe it possibly could, like, depending on how you shot or whatever the fuck. But it's like, if somebody's shooting like directly at a foot, there would have to be a hole. That, like, if it was a shot at the foot, it, like, it grazed it. It only, like, even went in the foot. It, like, it grazed in that. At that same time, it's like, how is it, how do you graze both sides of your feet or some shit? I don't know. That's kind of how you, I'm like, that. You got to be a good-ass shooter to be that accurate on the inside, nigga. Like, I don't know what that shit is, nigga. If I look at that shit, I'd be like, nigga, that shit from twerking. Take a couple of days off from that stripping and shit. You'll be right back on your feet. You'll be right back to it. No problem. Nigga putting, oh, look at my feet. Nigga, you're too much stripping. This is what it gets you, ladies and gentlemen. Girls, too much stripping. That twerk shit. That twerk shit. This is what happens when you do too much of that body. Yada, 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 yada. Yo, shit, nigga. You be doing that shit to death. Oh, girl. These heels is killing me. Yeah. 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 Nigga, put this on screen. Nigga, looking for sympathy. They putting everything on screen, nigga. Your shit swollen, too. Them angles are swole, nigga. Oh, you know what? Let me just keep going, nigga. Nigga, why her feet? Okay, never mind. Let's just keep the video going. But for real, though, did we all need to see the crusty musties? Did we all need to see the busted ass shit? Like, nigga. That shit like a reverse Reebok logo or some shit on you. Nah, man. But at the same time, like, you gotta really look at this. See how everything is cut? Hold on, where my arrow at, man? Get my arrow. No, I need my arrow skills. Look how everything is cut. This is glass shape. They said she kicked the back window out of a car. But yeah, she's saying she got shot. But this is like glass. And if somebody was to shoot you, right, it goes like a hole somewhere. You should be pierced somewhere. It doesn't like anything is pierced, like it could graze you at the most. But even a bullet would have just did this. It wouldn't have came out and did all this shit. If it was, like, what type of shit would that be? A shotgun or some shit would have spread out and it still would have did, it wouldn't have been like that. And at the same time, if it was one bullet right here, why do you have another scar right here? Where does this come from? Is this another bullet hole? Is this another bullet hole right here? But it could be from kicking in glass and destroying glass and your leg getting cut up from trying to kick in a window from trying to get out the car. Let me out this motherfucking car. Let me out. Kicking glass and shit and it breaking and you cutting your damn self doing this shit. That makes more sense. That's why you cut all jagged up like this, jigsaw shit, and then you all cut right here. That's glass. It's not bullet fragments. Really, though? Really, though? So what do we think, Screech? I think she's guilty, Screech. What y'all
guilty.
Think?
That nigga is guilty!
Nah, motherfucker. It's definitely guilty. Hella guilty, nigga. You know guilty. You know I ain't I gotta stop myself sometimes. I gotta remember where I'm at. I'm gonna say it's good. Alright. But just looking at everything, and when I sit back and I look at it, it's like, I don't see anything. And for people that really follow me, I watch videos, so people that follow me and they like those videos, like y'all, like we watch videos of people that shoot things, like we watch videos of bullets being shot, shotguns, rifles, handguns, we watch videos of like that, going through armor, going through helmets, going through metal, going through all kind of weird ass shit. We watch those little videos, we've been watching, like for my people that really was following me, we was watching videos like that, so we know when we look at certain things compared to even just like things that's supposed to stop bullets. a bullet is going to go through it, and it's going to make a hole. I don't see a hole here at all. It looks like your skin is peeled, and I'm seeing your meat and your bones and seeing other little pieces of your foot. But it doesn't look like anything has went through. And if anything was to go through, you know how many bones are in the foot? You wouldn't have been able to just twerk a couple weeks after. You would have had to start getting back to walk. How come we ain't get none of those videos? If you were shot in both of your feet, you ain't have to learn how to walk or nothing? It's like, you're not making no sense to me, Screech. But people are talking about it. People want to get on it. All right, fine. We address it. But some people really believe in this, so. But then some people really believe she's a good rapper. I don't think she's a good rapper. I really don't. I think she's good at the twerking shit, but then again, she's a stripper. So her doing the stripper shit is like she does anything for the money. I can imagine a stripper like her being in a locker room like, girl, I do anything for the money. I be over there like, oh my God, he shot me. I can imagine them over there just even doing shit like this. So it's just like, it's not unbelievable that you would be lying or even doing some shit like this and then blaming somebody else. But again, it's like when it comes to the evidence, it's stupid to put a photo like this. Like, only people that don't know what like a gunshot looks like would believe this. Only they would believe. Dude, even when bullets hit windows, doors, car door, like when bullets hit shit, it goes through a certain thing. It don't do no shit like this. That's why I'm just like, I gotta start thinking like, was it a shotgun? Like, what, did the shit spread or some shit? I'm just, but she was shot. But again, you got all these jagged pieces, and then how does a bullet spread and come and hit you right here? Maybe I'm wrong, Scritch. I'm wrong. You know you're right. Let her say her piece. I'm so wrong. I'm sorry. I'm insensitive. I shouldn't have said what I really felt and really thought. I should have catered to your feelings and your thoughts because your thoughts are way better than mine. I'm so sorry. I apologize. Me recognizing and acknowledging the inevitable is just so inconsiderate of me. I shouldn't let you know to even think any better than this. Let us say.
They took me straight to the hospital. And the police questioned me. And I said it was just glass.
You still stuck with that?
I stuck with it was glass. And right as the officers were like, okay, we done with this, we leaving. The doctor came in and he was like, you know, you got bullets in both of your feet. Like, you got fragments in this foot. And it's like, right on the back of your Achilles.
There is a medical report that says that there were bullets, that you had been shot.
Mm-hmm.
And the medical report also says that to this day, you still have
bullet fragments
in your feet. And there are still many people, as we sit here today, Megan, that don't even believe you were shot.
There is a hot gun in the car.
Yeah. The glass, did you go to the hospital?
So right they took that? Me straight to the hospital. And the police questioned me. And I said it was just glass.
You still stuck with that?
I stuck with it was glass. And right as the officers were like, okay, we done with this, we leaving. The doctor came in and he was like, you know, you got bullets in both of your feet. Like, you got fragments in this foot. And it's like, right on.
This shit. Nigga, I thought that was a fish. Is that your feet? Why would you put that on camera? You know what, Megan? I'm sorry. It does, like, the other foot, nigga, it like you was kicking some glass. I'm not gonna lie. Like, look, like these are two different stories. Those are two different feet. That's not it. That is not your foot. That is not your foot. That is not your foot.
Leaving. The doctor came in and he was like, you know, you got bullets in both of your feet. Like, you got.
Nigga, this is glass, okay? This is the film. Unless you're talking about these little... Oh, no. My error right there. Unless you're talking about these little black marks and shit at the bottom of her feet. The little fragments and shit. That's something else, nigga. That could be from missing. You over here showing this shit. This shit is from some other shit. You probably talking about this little black shit. Nah, nigga. That's glass and the bottom of your foot probably some...
Fragments in this foot. And it's like...
This shit look shot, nigga. Oh my God, nigga. Now listen. Motherfucker come up to me be like, I got shot, nigga. You did. Your shit is busted. Your shit is busted. Your shit is over with. You know what? I can't even. I'm sorry I'm even putting y'all through this, but we need to make an example. We just need to understand what's happening right now. Oh my God, you know what? Hey, Megan. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. You get an immediate apology. Your shit is busted. Listen, if I was outside and had pistols on my foot like that, I was saying nigga shot me too. Nigga, my nigga, your foot busted. Well, yeah, nigga, this little shootout is, you know what I'm saying? This shit happens. Damn. I swear, when they, you know, like, when people, like, on Discovery Channel, they catch a fish, the little fish on the side, like, oh, yeah, look at my fish. I thought that was a fish. I was like, she's showing feet. I'm like, nigga, look at your busted ass. Nigga, that's glass. Nigga, that's glass. They switch to this shit. I'm like, nigga, why the hell are they showing us seafood? I don't want to see no seafood. It's an ugly ass fish. I like. Oh, that I see the. Oh. 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 Oh no, hell! What the fuck is this shit? Megan. Listen. I don't know what toy shot you. Your friend shot you. Anybody else shot you. But this shit look busted. Somebody got to take the blame. Somebody got to. And I'm sorry. I really didn't believe you got shot. But your foot... Look shot. That shit looks shot out. Oh shit. I'm sorry that you even have to put a picture like this up. I'm sorry you even gotta even acknowledge this. I'm sorry you gotta expose this to the world, nigga. Is that really your feet? Is that really your feet? Did you really have to show the world? Did we have to go through the torture too? Oh. Hell no. Nigga, this shit, this black, is this the bottom of your foot? Oh, this shit look ugly, nigga. This shit look ugly. Why is it? It like you walked through South Africa, West Africa, East Africa. It like you done walked through all through Africa to this motherfucker. What the fuck? You done walked through Ethiopia with these motherfuckers. Traveled across Egypt and some old shit. Oh shit, nigga. It like you done been attacked by sharks and shit, nigga. Oh shit, why your shit look like this? Hey Megan, this was the wrong move. The wrong move. Nigga, if you wanted to give your haters anything, it was this. They gonna use this like a motherfucker. And if it was to do anything to gross anybody out about you, It'll probably be some shit like this, nigga. Like, you should have left these prisoners at the hospital. I would have highly recommended you just leave that with the nurse and the doctor. We don't need it. We didn't even want to see it. Nobody. Did anybody put out a request for that? Did anybody request? Nigga. They're like, you survived Jaws 5 out that motherfucker. That's crazy. I don't like this. I'm like, nigga, if you was to get anybody to feel sorry about anything out this whole situation, if anybody was to feel bad about anything, it would be this. It would be all of this. It would be the other picture, and it would definitely be this. You see why they say the best for last. Oh, you thought that foot was bad. Look at this one. Oh, damn. He did that to you. Nigga, you set him up for real. You blaming him for this? Don't blame him for your shit. You could have got a pedicure, nigga. You could have got your nails done and shit. She over here, she blaming this nigga for this? You know how mad I'll be. You know how mad I'll be. Like, imagine you have a girl. You got this girl you with. And then all this shit happened. And then she blame you and then say you did this shit.
What?
Me?
I did this.
I did this, all of this. Look how black. I didn't do that. Oh my God, Flame. That's incredible. That's undeniable, Flame. Nah. Megan, you're still guilty, okay? You're still guilty. Go ahead and turn my arrow down. We good right now. We gonna let the video play. I just want to get a little dialogue. I am Judge Rain, for those who don't know. For those who aren't acquainted. Bitch, you're guilty. Ugh, get that out of here, nigga. Oh, God, nigga. Command GT, nigga.
Guilty. That nigga is guilty.
Somebody had to take the blame for nigga, somebody gotta take the blame for this shit. Hell no. Well, let's get this nasty ass shit off the screen. But this is just. It's just incredible. Like, you really went, like, she going this far, nigga. Like, listen, if I was the judge, you did this to her. They setting you up. Oh. They setting you up, nigga. They setting you up. They done brought evidence. They got pictures, files. They want the world to see. Hey, look. Oh. They setting your shit up. Guilty. Guilty. Them niggas won't calm down about that shit, nigga. Them niggas going off, nigga. Them niggas is going off about that shit, nigga. I'm telling you. Let this shit just go. But this shit is... How you be feel about, like, nigga? She blamed this on you. If she blamed this on you, what you doing? Oh no, it was them. She pointed the finger and everything. It was you. And then she do an interview like this, showing pictures and shit. Like, damn. You know what? Shit ain't looking too good. Shit ain't looking too good. Like I said, if she was to make people feel bad about anything, it would be some shit like this, Chris. It would be some shit like this.
Class, did they believe you?
I don't know.
So how did you go from the glass. Did you go to the hospital?
So right they took that? Me straight to the hospital. And the police questioned me. And I said it was just glass.
You still stuck with that
I
story.
I stuck with it. It was glass. And right as the officers was like, okay, we done with this. We leaving. The doctor came in and he was like, you know, you got bullets in both of your feet. Like, you got fragments in this foot. And it's like right on the back of your Achilles. Mm-hmm. And I'm like...
There is a medical report that says that there were bullet that you had been shot. Mm-hmm. And the medical report also says that to this day you still have
bullet fragments in
your
my
foot.
Feet.
And there are still many people as we sit here today, Megan, that don't even believe you were shot.
There is a hot gun in the car.
Yeah.
What else? What happened?
In text messages obtained by CBS News, Kelsey Harris, the other woman in the car, texted Megan's security guard saying, help, Tori shot Meg.
I really thought that we were all friends. And it's sometimes I feel like I put the blame on myself because when my mom passed, I just felt like I was looking for some type of family environment. And I was letting so many people in. And I didn't care who it was. I just wanted to feel like I got family and I got people that care about me and just I could hang out with everybody. And I was just going through it.
What was the nature of your relationship with Tory Lanez? Because he has led people to believe that it was a sexual relationship, that it was that you two were dating. What was the nature
of your relationship? We were not dating. We were really close. We were friends. We hung out like every day. And his mom passed too. So when I felt like we were bonding over that. And
did you have an intimate relationship with him?
Like sexual?
Yeah. Did you have a sexual relationship with Tory Lanez? Yes, that's my question.
I didn't have a sexual relationship with Tory.
Shut this shit up, nigga. You see what this shit is, nigga?
This shit I be talking about, Screech. Why did this motherfucker have to stop, think, pause, wait a minute, think about it? This motherfucker really said, wait, what was I supposed to say again? Oh, yeah, nah, we would never even that. Nah. That's like somebody asking you, like, is that your friend? Is that my friend? Nah. That not my friend. Is that your best friend? I see you with him all the time. Is that my best friend? What take you so long to be thinking about shit like that?
I'm past two. So when I felt like we were bonding over that. And
did you have an intimate relationship with him?
Like sexual?
Yeah. Did you, Megan, have a sexual relationship with Tory Lanez? Yes, that's my question.
I didn't have a sexual relationship with Tory.
So why do you think he's putting out the story that the two of you had a relationship and that you're making the whole thing up?
I think that he is trying to deflect from the fact that he committed a crime.
Tory Lanez pleaded not guilty to assault and weapons charges related to the shooting. We asked his attorney about Megan's allegations in this story. She responded that they look forward to addressing Ms. Pete's claims, including her inconsistencies, discrepancies, and omissions when his case goes to trial later this year.
How has your life changed since you were shot?
I feel like my anxiety is worse. I feel like my relationship with people is it's gotten very cold because I'm not as trusting as I used to be.
I was going to ask you, is it hard for you to trust people?
Like, I've got this wall and I don't want to make any friends and I'm trying to be as nice as I can to everybody. I probably don't even hold a conversation longer than 30 minutes because I feel like every time I'm talking, I'm like on the verge of tears and I don't want to have to explain to strangers why I'm crying.
Yeah.
Half the time, I just want to pick up the phone and call my mama and be like, what do I do? Like, it's too much. I feel crazy. I'm sad. Like, and I feel like I have to hold it in because I have to be strong for so many people.
What do you say to people that still don't believe that you were actually shot?
I don't think any of this is for them. Like, it's for me. Like, I know this happened to me. Mm-hmm. And I'd rather it play out in court and the facts come out and everything comes out than me having to plead my case. And I'm a victim. Like, I'm the victim. Like, I'm not defending myself against anything. Like, something happened to me.
And following a pretrial hearing earlier this month, Tory Lanez was taken into custody and later released on bail.